Gillian's from Riverside, Connecticut, same hometown as Dorothy Hamilton. They were the national champions 2 years ago, second this year.
And their costumes are also in character of their music, two guitars from a Russian folk dance.
Potential tonight. Couldn't have looked better. Coming up, the last Soviet fair with a chance to displace Wachsman and Opadov.
Oh, good.
Gillian Wachsman and Todd Waggoner standing by for the march. Their coach, Pauline Dawes. Well, they are very good. 1-5-2 from the Canadian judge, but everything else up in the 5-4, 5-6 range.
Well, remember one thing, Jim. The Canadian judge has been consistently low through this whole thing. So you cannot blame her for that. That is clearly, clearly not something that this audience understands. All of her marks have been low, and lower than the others.
In other words, it's where she ranks them in regard to the way she ranked the other skaters. It counts.
Exactly. Her marks could be down in the 2.3. It wouldn't make any difference. Right. It's where they rank between the skaters. Susie Morrow Francis is also a very adventurous judge. Here again, she's lower than most of the other skaters. Most of the other judges.
Oh, we've got a 5.7 there. Another 5.7. American judge. And 5.2 from the Canadian again.
There's been a lot of good skating tonight, but you won the crowd.
Oh, thanks very much. We really tried this year to get it up emotionally, like everybody participates, and I think it happened this time.
The crowd was terrific, and it really gave us a lift. It was great.
Jim?
Okay, and once again, you get that feeling of just being an Olympian and feeling that you did your best out there, just like with the Seabold kids a little bit earlier on. Wachsman and Waggoner, the last of the American pairs here.